Hi, I'm Nathan Gray, and you're watching All Schools.
First of all, thank you for taking your time and do this interview with me. Have you had a great time at the Boys Tits Fire Tour so far?
Oh, yeah, it was great. It was awesome. It was. I would say more than we expected. I think all the shows were sold out. Everything went great. People were very... reactive to it, you know, like people really felt what we were doing. And it was also really cool to see some of the older fans that have been around almost since we've been coming here come with their kids. You know, that was really cool to see. So,
okay, this is really cool.
Yeah.
And now you can look forward to your tour in February in Germany, in Europe. And you just released a new song, Working Title, with Chuck Reagan. Mm-hmm. Why did you do a song with Jack Reagan together? Are you friends, or how did it come that you're doing a song with him?
Well, Hot Water Music and Boys Tits Fire sort of came up in the same scene. So we knew each other for a very long time. We became friends, and I've always loved Chuck. He's great. And when I wrote Working Title, I sent it to Oisey, runs End Hits, and you know, just sort of like, hey, this is sort of the material that I'm looking to do, this is what I'm writing. And he was like, you know what would sound really good on this? I was like, Chuck. The song almost sounds written for it, you know what I mean? Like, and so I texted Chuck, and it's funny because Chuck has this cool thing where he won't let you text him too much. He'll call you. And it goes along very well with his personality. Like, he's not going to sit there and have a long text conversation. Yeah, he's like, hold on, brother, I'll give you a call. You know,
the best way you can do it.
It's great. So. He wants, you know, how's the kids, you know, all that kind of stuff. Like, he wants to have a conversation and a human connection. And I really respect that. I love that about him. I can't say enough great things about him. That's really how it came about. And then it was really funny because I was talking to him like, yeah, I'll send you out the song and sort of what I'm thinking for the harmony. And after I thought about it, I was just, no, I'm not going to send you what I, you do what you do. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I was like, I'm not going to tell you how to sing. Like, it's really, like, so, and then he did a lot of great stuff on there. Just some very good backup stuff. That's very strong. Yeah. I like it. Yeah.
So cool. This sounds pretty cool and easy.
Very
to be
easy. Yeah. And I think that it will lead to a lot of working together down the road.
And to the title, Working Title, I wanted to ask you, it's like, Working Title is like, it's not really finished. Something is not really finished, you know? What actually do you mean with this? Is there a meaning behind it?
Yes. And there's a more serious meaning, and then there's a little more tongue-in-cheek to it.
Because so you want to tell me both?
Yes, absolutely. Perfect. And so the more tongue-in-cheek part of it is exactly what I expected exactly what was going to happen. I would say, I have this song Working Title, and people go, yeah, but what's it really called? You know what I mean? Like, and that's what kept happening. Like, people thought I was just messing with them.
Oh,
you know, yeah, like, it's called Working Title. Okay, when are you really going to name it? You know, like, so it was fun to, like, sort of play with that wording, you know what I mean? Because I knew people would react that way. They'd be like, okay, but what's it called? You know, no, it's called Working Title. Like, so it was, and it was fun to name the album that and everything. And then, but on a serious note, it was the whole idea behind the song is it is a motivational song from the point of view of a Working Title song. So it's basically the song personified speaking to the artist, like, don't give up on me, you know? And when you think a little more deeper into that, you think of not just a song, but you think of people in your life that need you to keep working, you know, that need you to keep sort of pushing, you know. Mm-hmm. There are people in your life that are hurting. There are people in your life that are working through depression and who have been left by others, you know. Yeah. And so it's this sort of plea from a song, a person, whatever, saying, look, together we're going to make this. We're going to be good enough, you know? But at this moment, our pieces are broken, but don't give up on me.
Oh my God, this is so beautiful. It's such a beautiful message. Really, everybody needs to have someone in his life or in her life who does things like that.
Absolutely.
It's really cool. Mm-hmm. And actually, that leads into the next question. What you were saying, your new album is way more positive than the first album. Mm-hmm. What was it that influenced you this time, or what inspiration did you have?
It was it was a journey from Feral Hymns, and being able to have the outlet of Feral Hymns helped me get to where I am now. So for the backup story, I went through some very dark times, and I was coming to grips with, in my childhood, dealing with sexual abuse. And for decades, I was unable to reach that place of dealing with it. And I had just buried it and pushed it down and pushed it down because it's obviously not an easy thing to deal with. So it was well into my 30s and 40s, still dealing with this. And I had gotten to a point where, because you can't hold it forever, it's either going to come out or it's going to kill you. And it was killing me. I was bloated. I had gained about 50 pounds. My eyes were sunken into my head. I have pictures that I can barely look at of myself. I was miserable. And I was slowly killing myself. And it was, number one, a very small group of friends that did exactly what I was saying.
Yeah.
That probably one of the coolest things was it was a few of my friends that were like, they noticed that honestly, I was being sort of a dick all the time to everybody. I was angry. I was hateful about everything. And several friends in several different ways came to me and basically said, look, I'm going to call you out, but I'm not going anywhere, you know? And I think that's like probably one of the most important messages you can hear when you're hurting, is that you know it's in love when someone is telling you what you're doing wrong, but that there's no way in hell you're going to chase them away, you know? So that started it. Then one night I sat down and I started writing Echoes, which is off of Feral Hymns, and which is very much about this situation. Mm-hmm. And it just all came flooding out. Mm-hmm. And I put the song together and I sent it out to Oisey at End Hits, who's also been a dear friend of mine for 25 years and a manager. And he was like, yeah, you should do this. Let's put this album out. And to be honest, at first I was a little angry at him. because I didn't want to put it out. You know, I was sort of hoping I'd send it to him. He'd go, you know, maybe not, you know? And I don't know why I expected him to do that, but, you know, so
maybe
I was,
you thought, oh my God, I don't want to tell anybody.
Right. Yeah. And then, I just thought ahead and like my heart is start beating, like I'm going to go on the road. I'm going to like sing this stuff in front of people, you know?
Like panic attack.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my God, I can totally imagine it.
Yeah. And so, but then I did it. And I got through releasing the album and the first tour, which, oh my God, the first tour was horrific because it was just me and a guitar by myself, spilling my guts out about this stuff and then sitting in a room by myself. You know what I mean? Just like, oh, kill me. Like, you know, that is the thing that really shocked everything into being, was putting myself into that. And the idea that anything, in Europe, you probably don't know this person very well, but in the U.S. there was a child TV personality named Mr. Rogers. Because at a time when children's television was a lot of like flashy puppets and loud noises, Mr. Rogers was a very calm show that dealt with very dark issues like war and divorce and things that kids were afraid of in a very calm and almost adult-like manner. Mm. because his idea was that if it's mentionable, it's manageable. So it gave a lot of kids my age a lot of hope. It's something that I've tried to bring into what I do now. It was a big inspiration. So in being able to mention my hurt, being able to mention things that had happened, it started to become more manageable. It started to become something that, okay, I can do this, you know? And if I can do this, then I can do this, and then I can do this.
Do almost everything.
And I started being more concerned about my health and my diet and my, you know, just things in general, and not like going on a diet, but just things I was eating, like eating better, doing things that were mentally and emotionally better for me. And everything just started to turn around. And so that leads up to Working Title, where I started to realize that, you know, I don't think that at any point, I don't think the end result is a full healing of things. Mm-hmm. I don't think it ever is. Mm-hmm. I think that life is this circular journey that has no end. There's no destination. You're not getting anywhere. Mm-hmm. You are just learning how to fail.
And to stand up again.
And that point between falling down and standing up gets a little shorter. And
at some point, you know how to deal with the stuff you're going through and stuff like that. I can't imagine how hard it must be to talk about something like this and to even sing in front of actually strangers. Mm. You know, it's so crazy.
It's hard, but I feel it's important because I think that I have to imagine in my head every time that there's someone who's not speaking up, but that's hearing it, you know? And that's actually been the case in a couple of situations where I've been able to play and then someone sort of pulls me aside afterwards like, hey, thank you.
Yeah, and that actually explains everything because the new album starts with "I found a brand new direction." Mm-hmm. And I always think about that when you were talking. I was like, that's actually exactly it.
Mm-hmm.
This is so cool. Mm-hmm.
And from there, I set the dynamics purposefully through the album because it's very positive overall, but I still have songs like "Mercy" and "Refrain" that are very dark and fallen. Yeah. And I almost was like, well, maybe they don't. No, they do, because that's part of life. Yeah. You need to realize that even in a positive life, that there are downfalls. You're going to fall. There are going to be points where you can't even imagine getting off the couch. You know, you're just numb and you're hurting. But at that same point, you know it's going to end. Yeah. You know, you're not stuck in it where you're like, this is never going to end. This is just my life. You go, I'm hurting now. Things are bad now, but I'm gonna lay here for a little bit. I'm gonna get over it, you know? I've watched you struggle all night.